In this video, I'm gonna walk you step by step on getting the best OBS settings for streaming on YouTube utilizing a Mac using OBS version 30. So the first thing you wanna do is you wanna come to settings. Once you're here, the first thing we wanna make sure is that we're connected directly to YouTube utilizing the recommended route. And you'll confirm that you're connected to YouTube by seeing connected account. Very important feature we want to head and select here, ignore streaming setting service recommendations, because this is going to give us some more customization and flexibility when we're setting up the settings. So super important that you select that there. Next, we're going to come to where it says output. This is where we're going to set up all the settings for our live stream to make sure that we're not lagging, that our quality comes out good, that our audio sounds good as well. Super important that you don't skip any of these settings or the definition of what the setting does. That way, if you run into any issues, you understand where to look and what adjustments to be able to make. So the first thing we're going to do here is under audio encoder, you want to select core audio AAC. Once you've done that, you come to audio and you want to make sure your track one is set to 320 to get the best audio quality possible. Then we'll come back here to streaming. And for the video encoder, for Mac, what I found to be the best to give you the best quality without any issues, and I'm utilizing an M1 Mac Mini with 8 gigabytes is what I'm utilizing to be able to stream. I use H.264 hardware encoder. So once you select that, the rescale output, leave it the same. I stream to 1080p on YouTube without any issues. This gives the most flexibility for all users on mobile, different devices to be able to enjoy your stream without any kind of issues. Then for rate control, I have that as CBR. Now the bit rate that I utilize is 9,000. This is what I found to be the sweet spot. However, the CBR is all dependent on what your internet speed is. So in the description of this video, I put a link to speedtest.net. You're gonna wanna come to that site and you're gonna go ahead and hit go. That's gonna give you your download speed and it's gonna give you your upload speed. What the CBR matters is the upload speed. So in order for you to have 9,000, this upload number needs to be at least 20, right? For you to be able to go ahead and have that. Because typically what I like to recommend when it comes to streaming is that you can go ahead and use half of your internet speed to be able to live stream. Now, I have 700,000. I don't need to go ahead and do 300,000 in speed. 9,000 is totally fine. So again, if you have 20, you can use 9. If you have more than that, you can use that. But I believe that 9,000 is a sweet spot. You can go higher to 18,000 if you want to do a 1440p stream. But again, that's going to be more your personal preference. So once you've determined what you can support with your internet, you're going to put that in the input that here. If you have less than 10, then you may want to go ahead and go down to a 720 stream. And you may want to put this bit rate at about maybe 4,500. Again, half of what that internet speed is going to be. Then for keyframe intervals, you're going to put that at 2. Profile, you're going to set it at high and then use B frames. I always have this unchecked. Again, this is what I feel gives me the best quality possible when I'm streaming. You can go ahead and test it on and off to see which version you like the best. Then once you have that in place, we now want to make sure that our video is going to look good on stream. So for your base canvas resolution, you want to make sure that this is set to whatever resolution your monitor is. So for me, I use a 1080p monitor, so I'm going to have it at the base canvas. And then for the output scale, I like to go ahead and just mirror what it is I have in resolution to make it easier for it to be able to process. So you'll put 1080p there as well. And then for common FPS values, now here's where I have it at 60, and you have the availability to be able to change this if you want to. If you're going to be gaming, you can go ahead and leave this at 60. If you're going to be doing more talking head to the camera, you can go ahead and put it at 30, which is totally fine. Then here under advanced, this is where you want to make sure that you have everything set up the way that I have it set up here for you to be able to go ahead and get the best looking video possible. Then once you have this in place, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and select manage broadcast. You want to go ahead and set up all of your settings here, add your thumbnail, your title, your description, your privacy, and the category you're going to be streaming to be able to create that broadcast to be able to go live. And then you'll be able to go ahead and start streaming, and that's going to push your stream over to YouTube. However, if you do not want to be able to stream and you want to use OBS to be able to record, the settings that I just showed you are not the settings for recording. So go ahead and watch this video right here to know the best settings to record on OBS utilizing a Mac. Click that video right there. I'll see you guys in the next video.